Hello everybody, it's me Khaled Al-Madani with you again in our summer 2008 training program. In these tutorials, I will be talking about Islamic finance and I will briefly touch upon the most popular Islamic instruments products as a mode of financing. I will be talking about Mudarabah, Murabaha, Musharaka, Ijara, Salam, Istisna'. I hope that you will enjoy this new episode. And now, let's start our journey. We will start with the definition of Mudarabah. Mudarabah is a special kind of partnership where one partner gives money to another for investing it in a commercial enterprise. The investment comes from the first partner, who is called Rabbul Mal. Please pay attention to this Arabic terminology because you will hear it a lot during this clip. Rabbul Mal is the person who owns the money, simply the owner of the money. In this case, he will be considered as the investor. While the management and work is an exclusive responsibility of the other partner, who is called Mudarab. So the Mudarab is the person who will conduct and will take on his shoulder all the management and work. Business of Mudarabah. Rabbul Mal may choose Al-Mudarabah Al-Muqayyada, restricted Mudarabah, where he will specify a particular business for the Mudarab, in which case the Mudarab shall invest the money in that particular business only. Or he, the Rabbul Mal, may choose Al-Mudarabah Al-Mutlaqa, unrestricted Mudarabah. Then the Mudarab shall be authorized to invest the money in any business he deems fit and appropriate. Rabbul Mal can contract Mudarabah with more than one person through a single transaction. He can offer his money to A and B both, so that each one of them can act for him as Mudarab, and the capital of Mudarabah shall be utilized by both of them jointly, and the share of Mudarab shall be distributed between them according to the agreed proportion. The Mudarab or Mudarabs are authorized to do anything which is normally done in the course of business. However, if they want to do an extraordinary work, they should get an express permission from Rabbul Mal. Distribution of the profits. The parties should agree right at the beginning on a definite proportion of the actual profit to which each one of them is entitled. No particular proportion has been prescribed by Sharia. Rather, it has been left to their mutual consent. However, they cannot allocate a lump sum amount of profit for any party, nor they can determine the share of any party at a specific rate tied up with the capital. To explain it, let's assume, for example, if the capital is 100,000 Bahraini dinar, they cannot agree on a condition that 10,000 Bahraini dinar out of the profit shall be the share of the Mudarab. Nor can they say that 20% of the capital shall be given to Rabbul Mal. However, they can agree on that 40% of the actual profit, remember, the actual profit, shall go to the Mudarab, and 60% to Rabbul Mal, or vice versa. It is also allowed that different proportions are agreed in different situations. For example, Rabb al-Mal can say to the Mudarab, if you trade in wheat, you will get 50% of the profit. And if you trade in fruits, you will have 33% of the profit. The Mudarab cannot claim any periodical salary or fee or remuneration for the work done by him for the Mudarabah. All the schools of Islamic fiqh are unanimous on this point. However, some scholars allowed for the Mudarab to draw his daily expense of food only from the Mudarabah account. Others restrict this right of the Mudarab only when he is on a business trip outside his own city. In this case, he can claim his personal expense, accommodation, food, etc. But he is not entitled to get anything as daily allowances when he is in his own city. If the business has incurred loss in some transaction and has gained profit in some others, the profit shall be used to offset the loss at the first instance. Then the remainder, if any, shall be distributed between the parties according to agreed ratio. Termination of Mudarabah. The contract of Mudarabah can be terminated at any time by either of the two parties. The only condition is to give a notice to the other party. If all the assets of Mudarabah are in cash form at the time of termination, and some profit has been earned on the principal amount, it shall be distributed between the parties according to the agreed ratio. However, if the assets of Mudarabah are not in the cash form, the Mudarab shall be given an opportunity to sell and liquidate them, so that the actual profit may be determined. This ultimate power of parties to terminate the Mudarabah at their pleasure may create some difficulties in the contents of the present circumstance, because most of the commercial enterprise today need time to bring fruits. They also demand constant and complex effort. Therefore, it may be disastrous to the project if Rabb al-Mal terminate the Mudarabah right in the beginning of the enterprise. Especially, it may bring a severe setback to the Mudarab, who will earn nothing despite all his effort. However, if the parties agree when entering into the Mudarabah that no party shall terminate it during a specified period except in a specific circumstance, it does not seem to violate any principle of Sharia. Dear friends, as I always keep saying, that learning can be fun. I hope that you had fun while you were listening to this topic.